my favorite sounds of summer. Please welcome to the mass stage, Ron Skjong.
Threw the gear on our backs, raised the canoes over our head and took off for the other lake. Finally got everybody over there, we slapped our canoes into the lakes and started paddling. We didn't get to our campsite until early evening. And everybody is tired. But we got work to do. Got to take the canoes out and secure them. We got to get gear out. We got to pitch tents. We got to make a bonfire. We got to make supper. We got to clean up for supper. We got to talk about the next day, do our planning. The cue for us to go to bed was to put out a campfire. So got about 11 o'clock, and of course all the boys there going like this. And so put the campfire out, and everybody dispersed to their tents. Now, as scoutmaster, you're the last one that goes to sleep, because you got to check to make sure everybody's where they're supposed to be. So I take my flashlight and go around to the tents and make sure the boys are all there, because you know, boys are the boys.
Yeah.
Not only that, but you take your flashlight and you go to the adult tents, because you know, adults are the adults. But everybody was where they were supposed to be. I crawled into my tent, and my two sons are on either side of me. The flaps of the tent are up because it's July, it's hot. We wanted some breeze going through the tent. I fell asleep. For some reason, about 2:30 that morning, I woke up. I sat up, I looked out at the end of our tent. There's the lake. Absolutely still. It's like a piece of glass. There's not a movement on it. And then, across the lake up in the sky, it's the full moon. And that moonbeam is showing across the water and right into our tent. It's magnificent. I'm thinking this is really cool. And then all of a sudden, about 50 yards out in the lake, there's a loon that starts swimming across that moonbeam. And then, off in the distance, there's a wolf that starts to cry. It is the most mournful howl I've ever heard in my life. And I want my boys to experience this with me.
Right.
Ever tried to wake up two teenage boys after they had a hard day?
Right.
They kind of are there. They woke up and then they flopped down again and went back to sleep. So I'm left alone. And that's all right. Suddenly, I sat there and I looked at that sight in front of me, and suddenly it hit me. Silence. Total, complete silence. Nothing. And it lasted for about a minute and a half. And then nature took over, a little breath of wind, and the lake started slapping on the shore. Nature started to sing its song again. But it's a moment I will never forget. You know, the sounds of summer are great. With our kids laughing and playing in the yard, or at the pool, or at the ball field, adults interacting over a cup of coffee, a beer, a cocktail, and better yet, a glass of wine. A concert in the park. Or just nature, wonderful sounds of nature. But I'll never forget that July 9th. 1999, I was privileged enough to experience absolute pristine